Hey mates, so in this video we're going over the MOTU 828es. This is audio interface. We're not going to really be going over the performance so much as this is a teardown, and more specifically we're looking at the chips that are inside this particular unit. We recently got this on the stream to do some repair work on, and when I opened it up I was very surprised and shocked just to see what was inside. So I thought we'd make a video going over all the different chips and everything that's in here. This is an older one, but I'm sure a lot of the stats carry over to the newer ones. We're mostly going to be looking at the analog to digital conversion, the DSP chips and management chips and so on. If you like this type of content, definitely hit that like button. And if you're new to the channel, subscribe. Let's get started. So we've got the unit here and the, so a bit of what's going on is a little bit of management. So over here we have the power supply area, and then here we have the main, I would say the main processing chip, the main unit. This is where the DSP and the MCU all live. And then over here we have the IOs and all that, all the analog to digital, digital to analog conversion is taking place out here. Let's start off with the main brain here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the chip here. So we've got the Xilinx Spartan 6. This is the XC6SLX25T. If we go over to DigiKey here, you can see it's AMD. And this is a pretty heavy duty thing. There's a we could go on about it. I mean the data sheet is pretty big on this. But if we look at the basics, you know, the breakdown here, we can see the number of labs, what is it, the logical array blocks. Yeah, logical array blocks, I always forget. It's 1,879. That's not too shabby. It's not too shabby, I believe. It says it has 190 IOs. Makes sense. But this, I believe, is basically the main core of the system. Now, if we go over to here, now there's a part that's blocking it right here, but if we see, we can see this chip here. Now, this is an alliance memory. This is the AS4C32M16MD1A. This is a 512 megabit SD RAM. It can run up to 250 megahertz. It's for mobile devices is its key market. Now, next to it, we have another chip here from that's this is the Micronix MX25L25645G. This is a 256 megabit CMOS flash memory. And if we go back over to the Spartan and we flip this up and we raise, we can kind of see in here. We might have to crank up the light. Yeah. So if we get in here, we can see that we have a T Texas Instruments OMAP L138E. Now, this is kind of a cool chip. I was looking this up. It's a where is it? It's a DSP chip. It's if we go to its page here, so it calls itself a low power C674X floating point DSP plus ARM9 processor that can run up to 456 megahertz. It's a 32-bit CPU. I believe that this is probably handling. the DSP. It has, I believe it, this one has the built-in memory as well. Ethernet's the protocol. That's interesting. Now, there is on this board here, if we go down, there is a port here for OMAP UART. So there is a way to program. There's the OMAP JTAG here. It's interesting. If we move further up on this, you have the this I believe is going to be the FireWire interface or the USB-C. Let me check real quick. Yeah. Oh, this is the Thunderbolt. This is the old Thunderbolt protocol. So this whole board here, everything above it is like a little card, and it goes to the Thunderbolt chip. It probably interfaces. They probably have it set up so they could swap it out depending on which system it is, if it's USB or if it's Thunderbolt or FireWire or what have you. All right, let's move on. And let's go to this rude boy here. So if we angle this a little bit, it'll show up. And we can see that this is an Altera. Let me pull this up because it's a mouthful. It's the Altera 10M02SCU169C8G. Now this is another FPGA. This one is a little bit smaller. It has 125. Logical array blocks. It has 130 IOs. Now, I believe this chip is handling management for the digital lines, for the analog and inputs and outputs. But just a guess. Okay, so that's all the chips. Next up, or what's left here, is the ADCs and DACs. What you're going to find is some pretty interesting stuff. I was impressed. So here's one chip. This is the AKM AK5574EN. Now, if we go and look this up, this chip has some very impressive specs. This is an analog-to-digital converter. It's a Gen 3 32-bit 768 kilohertz. Now, this allows true 120 dB. This is a prosumer-level audio device, and you're putting in 32-bit 768 kilohertz chips. Now, they're not running at that rate. But that headroom does have its own benefits. So there's one altogether, there's one, and then there's another one here. Let me focus this better. And then if we go over here, we have another one here. Now, if we look on the unit itself, we have our analog inputs here and our analog outputs here, and we have two inputs down here. These two chips are four channels apiece. They're handling the eight inputs here. This is four channels. I believe two of them are going to this, and then not sure where the other two inputs are on there. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Here we go. We do have time code in. It's possible it's grabbing from that. I don't know. There might be something. I may not be thinking of it, but we do have these inputs here. Now, speaking of these two inputs, let's look at. There's these two beefy chips for each one of these XLR inputs. Let's see what they are. You bet. Here, let's get one that's not burnt up there. We got the Burr Brown PGA 2500s. That chip is this guy here. This is a mic preamp. Has some pretty impressive specs here. It's a Burr Brown. So it's not, it's a good one. It's a nice audio quality pro level, quote unquote, I guess. I don't know where that lands anymore. But Burr Brown is an excellent brand and an amazing name. And that's how the mic preamps are. Let's keep going. We still got a couple more interesting bits here to look at. Now, if we cruise on over, we're going to see these ESS. Let me pull this one up. It's the ESS ES9016S. These are 8-channel DACs. They're 32-bit 8-channel DACs, 384 kilohertz. There's one here. And there's one here. Now, this one that we're looking at most likely feeds the 8 outputs. This one that we were just looking at feeds the 2 outputs here, and I believe there's some sends here, so I think it's part of that. There's still extra channels left over, and it looks like they may be tied to something, but I'm not sure. Now, this last chip that we have on here is the Cirrus Logic. Let me get this guy up here. It's the Cirrus Logic CS3318. This is an 8-channel volume control. This is sitting on all the inputs. You can see that it goes to each one of these op amps, each one of these pins. So this is basically the input control for all of them. It's controlled either from the front panel or via software. And if we go to this chip here, it says it right there, 8-channel analog volume control. Beyond that, that is what's inside that I could find on here. And I know there's going to be some stuff I'm missing. Feel free to comment below if there's anything that I might have missed or anything you might be curious about. Now, this won't be here for very long. We got this in for a repair. We did the repair, but as we were going through it, I discovered I saw the AKM logo and the Burr Brown logo, and I started to look at it and looked up the data sheets and was just impressed and blown away. I was like, what the heck? And personally, I've grown up not really having the highest regard for Mark of the Unicorn or MOTU as far as a hardware manufacturer. But after seeing this, I would like to amend my earlier beliefs. This is extremely nice. I personally, after looking at this, have decided that I wanted to swap my audio interfaces out that I have, which I've been wanting to get rid of anyways. And I haven't been able to find anything that would be a good replacement. I think we have a winner. I'm not sure which one I want to get, but as long as the guts are the same, I'm more than happy to take whichever version is out there, whichever version I can get a hold of. But yeah, this is just a quick video. I wanted to put out my thoughts on this, going over it. There's links to all the data sheets and Mouser links. They're not sponsored or affiliate links. They're just quick resources that you can get to the data. Like I said before, if you're new to the channel, you like this, subscribe, like, do all that. And I'll see you next time.